Thanks for tuning in. Welcome to the first day of the new month, December. And to that end, it's the final day of the month where US markets are concerned, and they had mixed fortunes over the course of the session. So at this stage, we're anticipating a slightly negative start for the local share market. But in terms of how the US markets finished, they actually came home with a little more gusto compared to the headwinds that they were running into over the course of the session. So the Dow Jones rose by 1.5%, the S&P 500 was up 0.4, and the Nasdaq was down by around 0.1%. So the point to make is that last night, arguably, we had one of the key events of the week come to pass in the form of the US PCE figures, so personal consumption and expenditure numbers. Within these figures, you have an important measure of inflation, which we always talk about. It's the PCE deflator. It's the measure of inflation that the US Central Bank looks at most carefully as its preferred gauge of what's happening with price pressures or inflation. So importantly, in relation to this outcome, it was in line with the market's expectations. So there's a whole range of figures that we can look at. Let's just make it simple and get on with our lives. The year-over-year improvement was, in annualized terms, was at 3% for this measure. So that was the lowest since March of 2021. But importantly, when you're looking at inflation measures, what you tend to gravitate towards to are the core numbers, which strip out the more volatile elements of the measure and give you a better understanding of what's happening with prices. So the annual rate of core inflation, according to this measure, moderated from 3.7% to 3.5%. So important, it's moderating, falling, and this is indeed the lowest measure since early 2021 as well. So the picture of inflation in the United States that we have seen fleshed out most recently is one of moderating price pressures, which is great. It's part of the reason why you have seen that steep fall where interest rates have been concerned over the course of the last month in particular. And it's that drop in interest rates that has been the lifeblood of the rally where stocks have been concerned. So you have seen the Dow Jones over the course of the last month improve by 8.8%. So that's the best outcome since October of 2022. You have seen the S&P 500 improve by 9%. So that's the best outcome since July of 2022. And you've seen the Nasdaq improve by almost 11%. So 10.7%. So that again is the best improvement since the middle of last year. So now it is a question of whether or not this improvement can be sustained into the month of December. And that was probably the interesting thing about the way that these markets performed last night, is that even though you saw that compelling news in terms of the PCE deflator being contained, you actually saw bond yields rise a little bit, you saw the stocks jig around a little bit. It wasn't an emphatic response. So you could make the case that perhaps investors were keeping their powder dry, big money managers thinking, okay, let's just rule a line under November, and then we will approach the final year, final month of the year on its merits. But it's starting from a good point given what we've seen with these figures. So it'll be interesting to see the way things pan out over the course of the next couple of days. We've continued to see encouraging moves when it comes to organizations reporting their earnings, particularly from the tech space. So one of the marquee outcomes last night was Salesforce. They had much better than expected numbers. You had the share price improved by as much as 10% at one stage. So some of the figures that they reported was an 11% increase where revenue was concerned. Their EPS came in substantially better than what the market had expected at $2.11 per share. So that was up by 50% over the course of the last year. They also had some interesting anecdotes in relation to company spending industry-wide on technology, that it was actually more encouraging than what the narrative suggests in the bigger picture. They also suggested that the margin and cost picture from a broader organizational perspective is improving as well. So that was good news, not only in terms of their earnings, but the description of what's going on in the business landscape as well. In addition to that, you had Snowflake. So they are another group that operates in this space. in terms of software. They had their shares rise quite substantially as well, up by about 8%. They had a very positive outlook. Their earnings per share came in at 27 cents compared to 16 cents per share for the last quarter. Sales came in at $734 million, so that was well above the $713 million that had been anticipated. And in terms of their free cash flow compared to the same time last year, that measure was up by 70%. So a very encouraging set of numbers as well. So that was part of the reason why you saw a lot of optimism around technology names in the software space, but wasn't necessarily reflected where the performance of the Nasdaq was concerned on the session, which was coming under pressure because of a bump higher where interest rates are concerned. So you saw 2- and 10-year government bonds up in yield terms, even despite those inflation numbers last night. So that's the thing to look out for again in the interest rate space, how those interest rates perform in the early days of the new month. The other important outcome to highlight was the performance of oil. So that was all tied to the developments in the oil space. So OPEC and allied producers had a virtual meeting last night, and they have agreed to extend production cuts up to close to 2 million barrels per day. But the fact that some of those cuts will be voluntary in nature, so that means that countries, individual countries, will be able to apply those cuts themselves and police themselves. This is problematic from a bigger picture because it comes down to a matter of trust and whether or not to be able to take it at their word in terms of production cuts within this cartel. And the market, that was the market's concern. So at one stage you had oil prices falling by as much as 6% before recovering towards the end of the session to be down by about 2%. So that's an important space to look at. There's another important reason why oil prices fell, because figures in the last month showed that the US production picture was very strong. There was record oil production in the month of September in the United States, coming in at around 13.2 million barrels per day, according to the Energy Information Administration. So notwithstanding what OPEC is trying to do in terms of price manipulation, you have got record output in the United States, and for one of the most important consumers of energy in the world. And that's part of the reason why OPEC and allied producers have struggled to get traction with their initiatives most recently and their oil cuts. So today on the local front, we're expecting, as I said, the local share market to kick off just in negative territory. We've got house price data to look at. We've got some PMI figures to look at as well. Look, to be frank, nothing terribly much to blow your hair back in terms of news updates this day. It is a question of how the new day and the new month pans out and what the risk appetite is on the part of investors, given the inflation picture, which in broader terms is shaping up as being one that is improving. It's just a question of whether or not that conversation around rate hikes starts to take more effect where the local picture is concerned, because the market's still expecting an additional rate hike from the Aussie, the Reserve Bank, in the near to medium term, not in December, it must be said. And the Aussie dollar is moderating, so it's trading just north of 66 US cents. Thank you very much for your company this week. Have a lovely weekend, and I'll talk to you again next week.